By the end of this tutorial, you will know exactly how to send email campaigns with ActiveCampaign. I will explain how you can create an email campaign, I will explain all these different types of email campaigns, and I'll also show you how you can actually send out the campaign. So let's just dive right in and then I'll explain how it works. So the first thing you need to do is you need to go over to campaigns, and then we're going to create our first campaign. Now then over here is going to ask us for a campaign name. So this is just for your own reference, so give it something that is easy to remember, right? So I'm going to call this one example one, and then if it would, for example, be a newsletter, you could maybe also include the date or something like that, right? Just something for your own reference. Now then over here we have select campaign type. So you have six different types of campaigns. So I will just quickly go over all of these and then I'm going to explain them all one by one. So we have the standard campaign type. This is basically the simplest one, and it just allows you to send a one-time email campaign to your whole list or a part of your email list. Then we have split testing. It's very similar. Also allows you to send out an email campaign, and then you can A/B test that email campaign by, for example, testing different subject lines. Really cool. I will explain that in a bit. Then we also have an RSS campaign type. And then with that, you can, for example, every week, check if there's any new articles on your website and then automatically send those out. Then we have autoresponder, and this is basically an automated campaign that will send after someone is subscribing to one of your email lists. Then we have date-based, and then for example, you can use that to send out a campaign whenever it's the contact's birthday, whenever they have an appointment, whenever they are on your email list for 1 year, something like that. And then we have automated. I'm not going to explain this one in this tutorial because this is just basically an automation, and I have separate tutorials about that one. So check that one out if you want to learn more about that. But over here, standard. Let's start with this one. And by the way, you can also find all the timestamps and resources below this video, right? Now then over here, we go to next. And then the first thing that we have to do is we have to select a list of who we want to send it to. So over here, what I could do is I could say, okay, I want to send it to my main list. So if I would now click next, then the email will just be sent to everyone on the main list. But what you can do is you can also segment the selected lists. And I think that's pretty handy. So what you can do is you can click this, then you see this down here, and then we can create a new segment for this email list. So then what I, for example, want to do is I want to send out this email campaign, but I do not want to send it out to people that are currently following my free email course. So to do that, I say here, not currently following free email course. Then we have to add a condition for this. And then the condition is not currently in automation, free email course. So then I click done. And then right now, this email campaign would be sent out to everyone on my main list, but not people who are currently inside that free email course automation. Pretty handy, right? Now then we would click here next, and then we have to create the email itself. So over here you can select one of the standard templates. You can also build one from scratch. You can go over to your past campaigns and then modify one from there. Or in my case, I have my own template over here. So I click here, use this template, and then I would call this one, I don't know, interesting tips, just an example, right? And then over here we click continue. And then over here we have the email builder. So I'm not going to write the whole email right now, but obviously you would have to do that before you send it out, right? Now then if you want, you can also go to this gear icon, and then you can also, for example, still change the subject line, the pre-header text, the from information, and the reply to email address. Then after the email is created, you click here next, and then we go to the summary tab. And this is basically going to give you a summary of the campaign. So here again, we'll tell you the subject line, the pre-header text, the from information, who the email will be sent to, and also, this is pretty handy, to how many people it will be sent. So in this case, it's 10 contacts, then your address, and then down here we have some options. So personally, I would always leave the open and retracking on so that you can actually see how many people are opening the campaign, right? How effective it was. Then also link tracking, I would also leave that on so that you can also see how many people are clicking links inside your campaigns. And personally, you do not have to do that, but personally, I do not like to use the reply tracking because then ActiveCampaign is going to change the reply to email address, which could look a bit weird for some people. So if I would toggle this to on, then you would also get a warning here about that. So that's why I leave this to off. And I'm also not going to use Google Analytics. If you would turn this to on, then it will ask you for a campaign name, and then it's going to add some parameters to links inside your emails so that in your Google Google Analytics reports, you can see where those people came from. So I'm not using that myself. Then we have the campaign archive. So if you want to set it to public, then leave it to public. Personally, I like to make it private because I do not want to share it online. I just want people to get the emails and that's it. And then what you can do is you can either just click here, send now, and then it will be sent out to everyone. So in this case, 10 people, or you could schedule it. So then over here, you could say, okay, I want to send it next week, or I want to send it on a specific date. Then I go over here, let's say I want to send it on the 1st of September, and I want to send it at 10 in the morning. So then over here, we do 10 in the morning. Then over here, you have your own time zone, and then you have to toggle this to on, and then you also see that this button now changed to finish. So now I click finish over here, and then bada bing, bada boom, our campaign was scheduled. So then over here, it says scheduled. Then over here under the column sent, it will show you when it will be sent or when it was sent. So that's also handy for past campaigns. Then also to how many people the campaign was sent. So right now it still says none because it has not been sent out yet. And then over here, last modified, and then the type of campaign. So this is the basics. This is the standard campaign type. And then right now, I want to show you how you can also use the split testing campaign type, because I think that's maybe my favorite. So to do that, we're going to create a campaign. And then I'm going to call this one example 2. And then over here, we go to split testing. We go here to next. And then again, we have to say, okay, who do we want to send this to? So let's say main list. And I do not want to select a segment. I just want to send it to everyone on my email list. And then over here, we can also select a split test type. So then we have two options down here. So either you can basically split test the whole email. So you can split test the email subject line, the from information of the email, and or the email contents of the email. Or you can just keep it simple and you can only test, for example, the email subject or the from information. So that's what I'm going to do now. I just have one email and I just want to test the subject line. So to do that, over here, I'm going to click next. Then we have to create an email again. So again, I'll use my template over here. And then I will say here, awesome tips. Click here, continue. And then you see that the email was created. So then you can just like write down your email, right? And then what is really cool is you can go over to this gear icon. And then up here, you see something to add a test. So if I click this button now here, then it's going to add test 2. And then I can, for example, give it a different subject line. Fantastic. Tips, or let's call this one marketing tips. So then right now we have one email, but then over here you can see that we have two different subject lines. And if you want, you can also change the from information in case you maybe want to test that over here. But so then we have that over here, the email is created. We go to next. So then we go to the summary of the campaign again. And then this is all the same. So here we always check like, okay, these two are on, they are off. Okay, this one I'm gonna make private. Now then you would schedule it for when you wanna send it out. And then down here, what I think is super interesting is that we have the split test options. And then what you can do is you can here basically determine the winner. So you can say here, I do not want to determine the winner. And then down here, you can just see that 50% will be sent the test 1 that we created, and the other 50%, it will be sent the test 2 that we created. So half of the list will get one subject line, other half will get the other subject line. So while I think that is pretty cool, what I think is even cooler is if we do determine the winner. Because what we could do then is we could say, okay, I want to send out this campaign with the two different subject lines, right? And then we could determine the winner based on the open rate or the click rate. So personally, depends on what the goal of the email is, but let's say we have a call to action inside this campaign. It's going to like a sales page or something, I don't know. And we want to check what the best click rate is. So then I would say here, click rate, and then determine the winning message after 2 days. So then what it is going to do, and you can also see that down here, it will send 10% of that email list subject line number 1, 10% subject line number 2, and then after those 2 days, the winner will be determined, and then 80% will be sent the winner of this split test. Super, super cool, right? So personally, whenever you send out like a one-time email campaign, I would always use the split test campaign type versus the standard type, because this way you can just really simply test subject lines, or maybe if you want also the content of the email itself. So now I'm going to schedule this. I'm just going to click here on, and then I will say, okay, I want to send this out tomorrow. And then I click finish, and that was that. Now then the next campaign type I want to show you is the RSS one. So then here we create a campaign, and then over here we'll call this one example 3, and then over here we select the RSS triggered. So personally I have to say I'm not using this so much. I think maybe used it once in the last 4 or 5 years, but it is there if you want to, and I also want to explain how it works so that you can decide for yourself if you want to use this or not. So we're going to select this one, then we go to next, and then we go over to lists. Then here, I want to send this one to the main list. And then if you want, you can also select one of your previously created segment groups. So then over here, I would say again, okay, I want to send it to everyone on my main list, but it should not be currently inside my free email course. Then I click here next. Then we go to design. And then over here, I go to my main template, and I will call this one latest new articles. New articles, let's do that. So then, okay, we click here, continue. And then this setup is going to be slightly different because we have to include the RSS block inside our email. So I have this email over here, right? So what I'm going to do real quick is I will duplicate this block, and then I will remove this, and I'm going to remove this over here. And then we just include the RSS feed block here. And then you have to give it the feed URL. So you would have to look up the feed of whatever you want to share, right? So I just want to have my own feed for my website. So in my case, this is maxvankollenburg.com/feed. So then over here, you see the RSS feed of all the articles on my website. So then, I'll just move this back. Then you will just put it in here. And then you see over here, that's going to give us a preview. So this is my most recent article. And then if you want, you can also customize this, because personally, I don't like it if it shows up like this. I can also maybe show you here, if I click now update, then you see that we get a block like this in our email. And I don't think that's so nice, right? So what you can do is you can click here customize. And then personally, I like to remove the date and also the description, and then items to show. Maybe let's set this to 4. And then you see that it already looks a little bit better, right? So then inside our email, you could for example say like, check out the latest articles. And then over here to get a list of those articles. So like I said, I'm personally not such a huge fan of this, but it is quite cool that it is possible, right? But I personally don't think I would do it like this. I think if I would send out campaigns with my new articles, I would prefer to write them manually to make it more likely that people are actually going to be interested in this email and more likely going to be interested in those articles. But hey, the option is there, right? So then over here, I click next. So then we get all these options again. And then this time we can, for example, say, okay, I want to schedule it. So let's say I want to schedule it for, now let's do here now a week later, the 8th of September. And I want to schedule it for 10 in the morning, 10 in the morning, click here on. And then here, what you can do is you can also set how frequent this same campaign will be sent again. So you could, for example, say check every day, and then if there is a new article, then the campaign will be sent out. So if there is nothing new, then it will not be sent out. This may be also handy to know, but you can, for example, also set it to every week. So then this is the first time the campaign will be sent out. And then every week after, it's going to send it out an email if there's any new articles inside the RSS feed. So yeah, personally, again, I do not like this so much because then you're always sending out the same email. But hey, maybe it is cool for some use cases. So then here we go finish. And then I want to go over to the next campaign type, and it is the autoresponder. So I'm going to call this one example number, I think this is already the number 4. And then here, autoresponder. Click here next. Then now you have to select the list you want to send it to. So I do okay, main list. Then we have the design of the email. So then here I go for my standard thingy. I call this one example. Click here, continue. And then we go to next. And then now if we go down here is that you see here this autoresponder option. And then over here you can say, okay, send to new contacts. So then it will be sent to new contacts on the email list that you selected. And then you can either say immediately, so you could maybe create some kind of welcome email, or you could say after a specific time frame. So you could say, okay, I want to send an email 7 days after someone is subscribed to an email list. So I'm not so often using this option also, because I much prefer to use automations for this, so that you can have like a proper onboarding automation. And then after 7 days, you maybe send something else. After 2 days, you send something else. I think automations are a bit better for that. But if you maybe have a specific use case for an autoresponder like this, then this is also there if you would want to. Now then, finish. And then I want to show you the last campaign type, and it is date based. So I call this one example 5, then here date based, we click here next, then we have to select the list we want to send it to. I'm not going to segment the list, I'll just click here next again. Then over here we have design, I'm going to add the email, and let's call this one happy birthday. And then here first name, title case, and I'm going to change this to lower. So in this way, it will say happy birthday, and then the first name in lowercase. So I think maybe it looks a bit more personal than just my own theory. So then we click here, continue, then the email will be created. And then over here, you would write like a short message. This is like, hey, John, happy birthday, make it an amazing day, blah, 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 blah. Here's a little present for you, maybe a little ebook or something, right? Then here, I click next. And then under summary, we can also set who we want to send it to, or based on which custom field, which is pretty cool. So then down here, you could say delivery, and then we can say here, sends on, and then if you want, you can also change this to before or after. And then standard here, you have the subscription date. So what you could do is, for example, you could say, okay, I want to send contacts an email on the subscription date. So maybe you like some kind of like, hey, so cool, you're already on the email list for a year, blah, 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 something like that, right? But if you want, you can also select here your global contact fields. So those are your custom fields. And as you can see over here, I have a custom field that has the birthday in it. So then what I can do is I can say here, sends on the contact's birthday, and then the campaign will be sent. So then here I click now, just click finish, and then it will only be sent whenever it's the contact's birthday. But obviously for that to work, you need the contact's birthday. But what you can also do, I, for example, also have a custom field called webinar date. And then I can, for example, also say before, and then here, 1 day before webinar date. And then you could maybe send a reminder email, something like that, right? But let's stick to the birthday for now. I will click here to on. So then this email will be sent on the birthday. And then over here, I click finish, and that is it. So campaigns are super awesome, but I think even more awesome are automations inside ActiveCampaign. I think that's where the real power is. So check out this tutorial over here so that you can learn everything about automations as well.